Okay. Okay. So, no, Purim. We said Purim. Learning Purim. Okay. So we spoke yesterday about I need the stem. Today, with the help of Hashem, we are speaking about the reading of the Megillah. Okay. Here we go. With the help of Hashem. Taf Reish Pei Zayin. Says the Shulchan Aruch, Hayav Adam Likro Et HaMegillah Balayla Ulachzor Lashanotah Bayom. The person have to read the Megillah in the night and read it again in the day. Veshelayla Zmanah Kol HaLayla Veshelayom Zmanah Kol HaYom. The night reading, you can read it all through the night. Day reading, you can read it all through the day. Ma'anetzach HaMa'atzor Efayom. From sunrise all the way to the end of the day. Okay, the question is it sunset or is it nightfall? But let's continue for now. Im kara mishalam od shachar yatzah. And b'dieved, if he read it in alot shachar before sunrise, he's exempt. Okay, let's see the Mishnah Berurah here. Mishnah Berurah Aleph. Likrot at the Megillah balayla, mish'atzet at the kohavim. What is the earliest time in the night reading? Tzedek Kohavim, rising of the stars. Ain gaman siman taf reish tzedek bet seyud dalet mishnah berurah beru halacha nirkadamnu sham. Okay, so we have to read on in reish tzedek bet. Bezrat Hashem, we'll get there, hopefully. Anyhow. נחזור לשנותה ביום, סז דמשנה ברורה, זכר הנס, שהיו צועקים מימי צרתם יום ולילה. So why do we read the Megillah day and night? Because in time of Mordechai ואסתר, they were screaming to Hashem day and night. So we are reading the Megillah day and night. Okay? כל הלילה, all the night through, עד עמוד השחר, until how do you say, dawn. Okay, עמוד השחר, until dawn. אם לא קרא קודם, if he didn't read it before, אפילו באונס, even if he was forced not to read it, שוב לא יקרא, he cannot read it after עלות השחר, after dawn, שלם עוד השחר יממו, because after dawn, it really belongs to the day. אוקיי? מה הנצח אמר? לפי שאין הכל בקיעין בעמוד השחר. זימנין דעתילה קדומי. סז דמשנה ברורה, why we say that the night finishes in dawn, so you cannot do the night reading after dawn. In the other hand, day reading, I tell you, don't start at dawn, start at sunrise. If the day starts at dawn, so then you can do the reading there of the day. Why not? So the Mishnah Berurah, because many people, they don't know exactly when is the time of Alot HaShachar, when is dawn. So they might make a mistake and read too early, whatever. So that's why after sunrise, so then you cannot argue about it, right? I said it also about the time that we're living in, that it's like people are arguing, is it really the redemption? It's not the redemption. Is it the beginning of the redemption? Is it the middle of the redemption? What is it, right? So I said this is like a lot of shachar. You don't, people are not baki, you don't know like to say, is it night, is it day? You can argue. But when there's a sunrise, when you see the sun, so you can't argue. It's like everybody recognizes that it's sunrise, right? So then when we get to that point in the process of the revelation, of the redemption, so then there won't be arguments anymore. Everybody will recognize it. Bezrat Hashem soon. So, says the Mishnah Berurah, because not everybody knowledgeable about when it's done, then they might do it too early. So preferably we have to wait for the day, for the sunrise, and then we can do it properly. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu Malach Haolam Shehakol Nehiya Bidvaro. Thank you. Okay. Mishnah Berurah Hey. Ad Sof HaYom. So the day reading, you can go all the way to the end of the day. So the Mishnah Berurah, Aynu Shkiat HaChama, that is the sunset. Okay, so we had this doubt, is it sunset or is it nightfall? So the Mishnah Berurah, sunset. Aynu Shach Ad Ben HaShemashot, Yigre'enu Bli Barcha. So what happened if the guy, he was not with us, as they say, until sunset, and only sunset is getting himself together that he's able to read the Megillah. So the Mishnah Berurah read it without a bracha, okay? Because it's a doubt. Ben HaShemashot, between sunset to nightfall, it's a doubt, is it a day or a night? So you can't do it with bracha, because maybe it's bracha lebatala. Okay, paragraph bet of the Shulchan Aruch. Mevatlim Talmud Torah lishmoa mikra Megillah. Okay, someone that is nervous about Bitul Torah, that he doesn't want to go to hear Megillah because it's Bitul Torah for him. So you teach him this paragraph. You do Bitul Torah to go to hear Megillah. Kal v'chomer l'sha'a mitzvot shel Torah shekulam nidchim mipnei mikra Megillah. And how much more so all of the rest of the mitzvot. Even Talmud Torah is pushed. How much more so other mitzvot? We have to go to stop everything and to hear Megillah in Purim. En lecha davar shenidcha mikra Megillah mipanav. What can push away mikra Megillah? Says the Shulchan Aruch, nothing besides met mitzvah she'en lo kovrim. You know the concept of met mitzvah? If you find a dead body and there's no one that is there to take care of it. You have a chas v'shalom, not here, not anywhere. There's a dead body lying, and no one is taking care of it. There's no one that is taking responsibility over that. So that's called the met mitzvah. You stop everything, and you're taking care of the met mitzvah. And you can bury him where you found him. You don't have to carry him anywhere else. The met mitzvah konem mekomo is inquiring the place where he is. No one can say, it's my field, it's my place. No. This is the met mitzvah, so inquire his place, you bury him in that place, and that's it. You have to make sure that Bezrat Hashem, no one will have this experience. Anyhow, so someone that is dealing with met mitzvah, so then he will be exempt from Mikra Megillah. Okay, if he takes him the whole day, so he missed Mikra Megillah. He was dealing with other mitzvah. Okay, so the Shulchan Aruch, Shapogia Bokovrot Chila Vachaka Kore. If somebody found a met mitzvah to bury, so then you have to bury him first, and then if you have more time to go to hear Mikra Megillah, so then he should do that after, when he finished the burial. Okay.
So I just wanted to see, you find a dead body, that's a legitimate reason to not go to hear at the time when...
If you're dealing with the burial of that dead body, if somebody found a dead body and he continue in his way and he's not doing the mitzvah of burying the dead body, so it will not give him the to be exempt from Mikra Megillah, right? Just if he takes that responsibility and he's performing that mitzvah to bury the mitzvah, then as long as he have to deal with it, so he is exempt from the reading of the Megillah.
So should he just, I mean, in other words, is it more of an obligation to bury the body or to go hear the Megillah?
I just said to bury the body.
Okay.
To bury the body is the first priority. What do you want to ask?
Of Shepherd?
Yeah.
What about Bezman Hazeh with COVID? Can one fulfill his obligation to hear Megillah over the Zoom?
Okay, that's a tough question. To hear Megillah through Zoom. That's a tough question. Look, if there's no other way, so it's better than nothing. It's better than nothing to have the reading and to follow the text. I would say that in a case like that, it's better for you while you hear it, also to read through yourself the text, to say it with the Baal Koreh together. So you have to find someone that is reading not so fast, that
right.
You can follow through, and to read it yourself, because it's a doubt if you are Yotze when someone else is reading and it goes through the
right.
It's not simple.
What about if
there are lenient about it, And in a case like that, that someone is, that he doesn't have anything else to do. So I would say, yes, you can rely on that. But if it's
what about if,
to follow and to say over the text yourself, it's better.
What about if I read it, but I don't know the trope? I just read without the music.
From a book. You can be yotze in reading without the vowels, without the tamim.
Okay.
How do you say vowel tune?
If you can get
the kosher Megillah to read for, so that will be much better.
Of course. But okay, thank you.
Possible, it's not possible. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I believe that probably there is people that are selling Megillahs in LA. There is a big Jewish community there. I have no idea what the price is, but I'm assuming that it's about $2,000. You say? Okay, could be. In Israel, it's not much cheaper. It's also will be probably $1,500, for a nice Megillah, something like that. I believe.
For a nice one?
Not fancy. There is all kinds of fancy ones pictures, these, that, special boxes with silver and gold. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking kosher Megillah. That is nice writing, not nice fancy. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Anyhow. Bezrat Hashem. Bezrat Hashem, everybody will have their own Megillah. It's as much as possible, it's good to have a kosher Megillah. We're going to read it inside soon in the Shulchan Aruch, but I will say it now outside, that the problem is that when you hear that someone else reading from Megillah, so if you miss the word that you didn't hear him saying because he didn't say it properly, because you were whatever, somebody called you, somebody tap on your shoulder, whatever it is, You missed a word, a few words, so then you have a problem, because you need to have every word. So you can't tell, if you're not a big rebbe, you can't tell the Baal Kore, hey, stop, go back. I missed a sentence, right? It's going on, it's continuing. So if you have your own Megillah, so you can read yourself that piece that you're missing, and then continue to follow along, to catch him and to keep on listening. But if you don't have your own Megillah, so then you have a problem. You're not exempt in that reading. So that's the reason. Even when everything is okay, without COVID, without anything, and everybody are in the Bet Knesset and everybody are listening, but many times you have situations like that. The Baal Kore, he wants to rush it. He wants to read it quick, and you don't hear all the words. So, okay. Generally, it's an issue. So when I'm reading my Megillah, I'm trying to say it slowly, that it will be easy for people to follow through. But it's a question. You have to find somewhere that it will be a reading that fits you, that you can listen to every word. Anyhow, let's read the Rama here. The Rama says, "Kol ze lo mikri ela b'deika sheud la'asot shten." אבל אם אי אפשר לעשות שתיהן, אין שום מצווה דאורייתא נדחית מפני מקרא מגילה. Why? Very, very strong. The Rama says, all what we said is true, meaning what we said about the met mitzvah, right? That you have to bury someone that you found, that it comes before the Mikra Megillah. Says the Rama, that's only when you have time in the day to do both of them. But if you know that if you start to deal with that met mitzvah, you will not finish before sunset, and you don't have the Mikra Megillah, says the Rama, even that will be pushed away because of Mikra Megillah. You have to have the Mikra Megillah. Amazing. Yeah. And shuv mitzvah deoraita nidred mipnei Mikra Megillah. There's no deoraita mitzvah. Met mitzvah is the most extreme example. There's nothing more than that. Yeah, so if that is not pushed, so nothing is pushing. Yeah. But the met mitzvah kodem, ayinu davka deefshar lo likroa achar kach. So again, when do we say, according to the Rama, that to bury the Met Mitzvah will come before the Mikra Megillah? Only that you can finish with that and go to hear Mikra Megillah in the same day. Then you can do the Met Mitzvah first. Let's see the Mishnah Berurah here. בית, מבטלים תלמוד תורה, זה לומר, עבד תלמוד תורה שכול כנגד כל המצוות, so even though learning is equal to all of the מצוות, right? תלמוד תורה כנגד כולם, right? We say that every morning. So the תלמוד תורה is like, so I explained one time why the תלמוד תורה שכול כנגד כל המצוות. Because all of the rest of the מצוות depends in the תלמוד תורה. You cannot do anything that you didn't learn. So to be able to do any mitzvah, you have to learn about it first. So Talmud Torah, when you learn it, it's a mitzvah, and also that what permits you to do all of the rest of the mitzvot, right? Anyhow, אפילו היינו Talmud Torah של חבורה גדולה, של 100 אנשים שלומדים באיזה בית, אפילו אחי צריך לבטל ולך לקרותה בציבור משפני רוב המטרת מלך. Okay, so the Mishnah Berurah is saying, let's say you have a situation that you have 100 students that comes to your house and listening to your Dvar Torah, and you can continue to speak. They want to hear your words of Torah, but you know that now it's time for Mikra Megillah. Okay, so what will be the right thing to do? Says the Mishnah Berurah, it's better to stop and to go to the place where everybody are reading, the congregation that you belong to reads the Megillah, to have Berov HaMadrat Melech. Okay, so even though you have 100 people in your house and you can do the Mikra Megillah by yourself in your house, but it's a big thing to read it in public. To it's a praise to Hashem. By the way, that's a general concept. Rov HaMadrat Melech, whenever you can do something with a bigger crowd, it gives it a higher quality. Okay? The question is when you have a bigger crowd, but in that bigger crowd, so it's not the place where you want to be, for example. You have people that are doing things that you don't want to see, or speaking things that you don't want to hear, or all kinds of different things, that it makes it hard for you. So then it becomes to be a question. What is better, to be there or to be by yourself? Okay.
Is a bigger crowd, is more kavod, or it's more energy, or it's more,
the principle is called Rov HaMadrat Melech. It means when you have a bigger nation, it brings more like honor and glory to the king. Yeah, I heard once, I don't know where I heard it from, it was probably like a few years ago, that in the beginning of the interaction between China and United States, so there was like a group of like whatever, like the leader of China that came with a big like group of people to visit the States. And the people there in the States, they were like amazed from like the amount of people that came with him. It gave him like the fact that he brought so many people with him that were like escorting him, that was wow. Like we didn't see like something like that for a long time, you know? So
I don't know. It's entourage.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, so it's a concept in the world today. You see that as well. Yeah, for sure in the past that they have like parades like that to make for something, you know, to celebrate something. So when you have a big crowd, so it brings glory, it brings kavod, respect, whatever, right? Today you like all the you want to bring to attract attention of the media, whatever it is. So you have to have people with you. As much as you have like more people, so then you attract more attention. Okay, so lehavdil ben tam ben tamel kadosh, right? Hashem wants us to gather together to praise him. So when we're gathering together, like, and there's a bigger crowd, so it brings more glory to Hashem. So it's we have an opportunity to bring more glory to Hashem. As much as we can, we have to grab every opportunity like that. Okay, if it's not possible, it's not possible. Yeah, there's many people that are good people and they're not going to big shuls. Like I said, because there is all kinds of problems that there's people that speaking Lashon Hara, this, that, you know, they don't want to be part of that. The congregation is davening too fast and they're locking the shul, whatever it is, all kinds of stories. Okay, so if you can't do it, you can't do it, whatever reason. But as much if it's possible, so it's a good thing. It's a bigger mitzvah. Anyhow, says the Chaye Adam, מכל מקום מי שמתפלל כל השנה בקביעות במניין המיוחד להתפלל שם אין צריך להילחל לבית הכנסת. If somebody have all year long a certain minyan in his house, in a, like some bit midrash, that is a small minyan, And that's where he's davening every year. So then also for Purim, he can do the Mikra Megillah there. He doesn't have to be to go to the big synagogue that it will be like Berov HaMadrat Melech. That's his place. So that's his place. So he continues in his place. Mishnah Bruachet, Kedei Tzorko. Meleshon Zeh Muchach, De'af Shehu Ba'ir, She'en Lo Kovrin. Shuv Eino Mutal B'Bizayon. Okay. So again, what is the definition of Met Mitzvah? Okay. Says the Mishnah Berura, if the dead body is in the middle of a city and there is people there in the city that are able to take care of the burial. Yeah, today that you have like Chevra Kadisha, that they're taking care of like any person passed away, they are in charge of burying him. So that means that there's no disgrace to the dead body. Okay. As a result of Govro, Kodem, Rak Tosefet Kavod Lo. So now you might say, hey, but right now the Chevra Kadisha are not around. They are busy with a different burial. Maybe it will take them some time until they will get back here and they will be able to take care of it. So what should they do? Should I take care of it myself? So then the Mishnah Berurah says, this is not the definition of Met Mitzvah. Okay? Met Mitzvah, it means that there's no one else that will take care of it. You have to be the person. You have to make yourself to be that man that takes the responsibility. Okay? But if there is a group of people, Chevra Kadisha, that's what they do. They're taking care of burying people that passed away. So the fact that the dead body have to wait a little bit, and if you do it, so it will be faster. So you're right. You have a mitzvah there, still a mitzvah, to make it that the burial will go faster. But it's not the definition of met mitzvah. Met mitzvah, it means when there's no one else that will do it, even if it will wait. Okay, it won't help to wait because no one will come. That's met mitzvah. Says the Mishnah Berurah, if the case is that there is someone that will take care of it, just the dead body will have to wait until it will happen. Okay, then it will be a question. What should you do? Should you do the Mikra Megillah first and then take care of the dead body? Or even in that case, you can still do the burial and then go to hear the Mikra Megillah. So the Mishnah Berurah, even in that case, you can first do the burial and then take care of the Mikra Megillah. כן משהו מבהגעה, סוף סימן תף ראש צדיק. ואו, תסביר על התגבורת מתו קודם. Okay, so there's another question. Is it your, like, חס ושלום, not for anyone, if it's someone, a relative, so then there is a bigger mitzvah because it's the responsibility of the relatives to take care of the burial, right? So if that's the case, so then it will be more stringent. So there we're talking about his personal relative that he needs to take care of. So the Mishnah Berurah is making that connection. Like there, you have the permission to take care of the burial and then to go to hear the Mikra Megillah. So also here in Met Mitzvah, you also have that permission, okay? So if it's a real Met Mitzvah, it's simple because it becomes to be like your relative. It becomes to be like your responsibility, right? But in this case, the Mishnah Berurah is talking about, it's a big chidush because really you have someone that will take care of it. And still you have the permission to push out the Mikra Megillah for the meantime because you want to make it faster. Okay, let's continue. המגן אברהם מביא בכשם כמה פוסקים לסביר עליו דווקא מת מצווה, משהו שמצאו בשדה, שהוא מוטל בביזיון, שאין לו קוברים כלל, אבל בעיר שיש לו אנשים שדואגים בעבורו, נקרא מגילה קודם. Okay? And here you have the second opinion that the Mishnah Berurah brings, which is the Magen Avraham, that he holds not like that. The Magen Avraham says, no, met mitzvah, did you find in the field that there's no one that will take care of him and he's like lying like in this way of disgrace in the middle of the field, whatever it is. So then you have the permission to push away the Mikra Megillah and to take care of that. But if it's in the city and you know that someone else will take care of it and it's not such a disgrace, so then it's not pushing away the Mikra Megillah. כן נסכים ביור הגרה להלכה, כן כתב שאם התחילו להוציאו, הם מפסיקים באמצע, אז נדחה מקרא מגילה לגמרי. אפילו אי אפשר לקרוא אחר כך. אוקיי. So the Vilna Gaon, he basically agrees with the Magen Avraham. But he says, if you already started to take care of the burial, you started to do the burial, להוציאו, to bring it out, bring that body out to the burial, so then you don't stop. Then for sure you have to continue and to bury the dead body. Okay. And also the Pri Chadash also agrees with that. Okay, next Mishnah Berurah, Tet. Diga She'ut, when you have more time. Kuadin Linyan Mila or Megila. Okay, what about when you have Brit Mila and reading of Megillah? Says the Mishnah Berurah. Imika She'ut Lasot Shteyeh Mikra Megila Kodem Mishum Pirsum Inisa. העולם נוהגים למול קודם המגילה. So it's a question. למה is it the Mishnah Berurah? Do you mind to open the door? The Mishnah Berurah says that really you're supposed to do the Megillah first, to read the Megillah first, and do the Brit Milah after. But he says that the world custom to do the, oh, Shalom Aleichem. The world custom to do the Brit Milah first. You can have a seat over here. There's a place for you. You can do the Mikra Megillah, you should do the Mikra Megillah first, but the minhag of the world is to do the Mikra Megillah after, to do the Brit Milah first. Okay? Yud. אם אפשר רוצה לומר שהתבטל המצווה דהורייתא לגמרי, אם לא יעשנה ביום ההוא. מה שקורה לכמן. Okay, so again, we said, if you have the possibility to do both, so then you have to do first the Met Mitzvah, and then the Mikra Megillah. According to the Shulchan Aruch, right? And according to the Rama. If you can't do both, so you should do the Megillah first and the Met Mitzvah after, according to the Rama, right? But now the Mishnah Berurah is adding that if by you going to do the Mikra Megillah now, you will not be able to do the Mitzvah Deoraita after, not that it will be pushed, it will be canceled. You won't have it anymore. So then the mitzvah deoraita takes over the Kriyat Megillah, which is the Rabbanan. Okay? So for example, we spoke about Met Mitzvah. So if Chas V'Shalom, there's a danger that if you will not take care of it now, animals or like some enemies or whatever will take that dead body and no one will be able to do the burial afterwards. So then obviously you have to take care of the burial before the Mikra Megillah. And even if you won't have the Mikra Megillah after, because it's already noontime and until you'll take care of it, it will be the next day. Okay, what can you do? That's what the Mishnah Berurah says. Kegon mipnei listin, kei gavna. So then for sure the Met Mitzvah comes first. Mishnah Berurah Yod Alef. En shu mitzvah deoraita nidchet v'chulei, mipnei shemikra Megillah rak min derabanan. שהביא בשם הרשאל וברדה תמיד מקרא מגילה קודם משום פרסום מניסה. So again we have this discussion back and forth between, like, what is more important. On one side מקרא מגילה is the רבנן, so every מצווה דאורייתא is should be more important, but on the other hand you see that Chazal was so like emphasizing the importance of מקרא מגילה because of פרסום מניסה, because we are speaking about the miracles of Hashem. Right, so it's strengthening the bring kiddush Hashem, strengthening the faith of Hashem. So it's very important. So that's the reason to do the Mikra Megillah first. So there's different opinions about it. Okay, shalom lekora. Aval, I'm reading Mishnah Berurah Yud Bet. Aval, im usamur lechashicha ikra Megillah, de'amet mitzvah afshar lekovro balayla. So if it's already close to sunset, so you should read the Megillah, because after sunset we said it's already night. Okay, Met Mitzvah, you can do it night. You can bury a Met Mitzvah in the night. So again, you have like something that's gonna flow away if you won't do it now. Grab it. אפילו אם נפסק שם ושאר מתים, גם כן מותר מצווה להקדים קבורתו לקריאת מגילה, כל פנים איך הדי ידחה, על ידי זה קריאת מגילה לגמרי, בוודאי מקרא מגילה קודם, וקבור מתו בלילה. So, okay, so here the Mishnah Berurah is summarizing the whole thing, and he basically says like this. You have one issue, which is a disgrace of a dead body. Met mitzvah that is in a place that is like disgrace. There's no one that is taking care of it. So that's a big thing. That's like you have a problem for the briot, you have a problem for the med. You cannot ignore it. You have to take care of it. That's before everything. Okay? That's a real met mitzvah that there's no one else that will do. If you have met mitzvah that someone found in the city, and there is like Hevra Kadisha, there is people that will take care of it. It doesn't have to be you, but you found it. So if you will be there and push it and take care of it, so it will move things faster, and the dead body will come into burial faster. So you have a mitzvah there, but it's exactly the idea of met mitzvah. Okay. So then there's a question: what should you do first, the met mitzvah or the mikra megillah? So the Mishnah Berurah says, even if you say that the met mitzvah will come first in a case like that, that's in a case that you can do both, like the Rama says. But if because of taking care of the met mitzvah, you won't have the mitzvah of mikra megillah because it will be until after sunset. So then for sure, you should do the reading of the megillah, then to take care of the met mitzvah. Okay? Zohar Hashem will hold it here. Thank you very much. Baruch Adonai l'olam, amen v'amen. ברכה והצלחה.